Hey everyone, this is Mir from Learn English with Mir. Welcome to my channel. If you are new to this channel, I would remind you to go through all the lectures based on root words. So this is lecture number 7, and in today's lecture I'm going to discuss the root word Bon, Ben and Benny, which means good, well or kind. So, a little reminder about root words, that we use root words as a tool to enhance our vocabulary easily as well as quickly. So let's get started. The first word I've selected is bona fide. I hope this is a word you're already familiar with. You might have used it in your conversation, in your writing, all right? Now let's break it down and see what it means. So it has two root words. The first root is bon, which means good, and the second root is fide, which means faith. So bona fide means to undertake in good faith. Let me give you a practical example. Let's say that if a student wishes to switch one school and move to another school, so the student is required to present a certificate, alright? So now the certificate somewhere were mentioned the name of the student, the details of the student, and the certificate will comment on the behavior, attitude, manner of the student, and hopefully the word bona fide will be used somewhere in the certificate. Now the certificate undertakes, or the one who provides the certificate undertakes it in good faith, that the mentioned student is good, all right, as far as discipline, all right, and behavior is concerned. So the person authenticates it, right? So the word bona fide means something that is presented in good faith. Right? So let's look at this example. Only bona fide members are allowed to use the club pool. Now, what sort of members are allowed to use the club pool? Bona fide members. Now, what is meant by bona fide members? I mean good members or authenticated members. Right? So, not everyone is allowed to use the club pool. Right, I hope you've understood. Now let's move to the second word, benediction. Alright, let's break it down. Again, this word has two roots, ben, the first root, and dict, the second root. Now ben means good, and dict means to speak, like dictionary, diction and so on. So someone who speaks good for others, or the act of praying for divine protection, is called benediction. Let me give you an example. Let's say that somewhere in the streets you came across beggars and they were begging you. So if you help out a beggar, and in response the beggar will benedict. Now what is benedict? Now this happens, all right, and you might have noticed it, that whenever you help poor people, or let's say beggars, so in response, let's say the help could be giving them money or any sort of help, so in response, they often benedict. They often use kind words, good words. They speak good about you. And often they say, they use certain words and phrases of prayers, right? Okay, so example sentence. The newly married couple received benediction from their parents and family members. And I guess this happens. So if someone gets married, so the family members and friends benedict. Okay, they use good words such as that your marriage should prove successful. Okay, you should spend a happy life. May God bless you, and so on. So that is what? Benediction. Great. Let's move to the next word. Beneficent. Now, what is beneficent? Let's break it down. Now, Bene means good. Alright. So, the second half is not a root. So, as a result, what is beneficent? Doing or producing good, all right, is beneficent. Someone who helps people and does good act is beneficent, right? Okay, the beneficent institution maintains a scholarship fund for needy students who wish to attend the college or university. All right, now what is the institution doing? Is providing funds for students who wish to attend college or university. So the institution is called beneficent, right? So because it's doing something good. All right, now let's move to the fourth word, benevolent. So as usual, let's break it down. Ben or Benny means good, right? Now the second root is vol, which means wish or will. Like this root somehow appears in volunteer. So a volunteer is someone who performs his duty on his own will. He's not forced to do it, right? Okay, so intending or showing kindness. Someone who wishes, it's not God, it's good, sorry, for others, right? So someone who wishes good for others. So the person will be called benevolent, right? Example, he was a benevolent old man. He won't hurt a fly. Okay, so now in this sentence, the man is benevolent, means he's good, he's very kind, all right, and he didn't hurt a fly. Okay, so a benevolent person wishes to give benefits for others, right? He's very kind, all right, and he tries to help people or do good for others, right? So let's move to the next, the fifth word, benign. So the fifth word on my list is benign. So Ben means good or well. There is no other root. So let's see what benign means. Pleasant and beneficial in nature. So something that is good is pleasant. Yeah. So something that is pleasant and beneficial in nature. Let's look at this example. The tourist enjoyed their summer trip in the benign climate of Gilgit, Baltistan. So, as you know that these days, the summer is at its peak, alright? So, the temperature in downtown is high, okay? It's soaring. So, tourists love to visit the upstream, I mean, the northern part of the country, where the temperature is somehow, what? It's somehow low. So how so the tourists find their trip is benign, all right? So the climate is beneficial for them, all right? So they feel good just because the temperature is low, okay? The climate is good, all right? So they feel good, all right? So what is benign? Pleasant and beneficial in nature, right? So anything could be benign, right? Something that is pleasant and gives benefit is benign. Next, benefactor, all right? Bene means good or well, and factor means do or make. So someone who does good for other, now what he or she does, thinks good, I mean works for the welfare of others, benefit of others, is a benefactor. A person who helps people or institutions, especially with financial help. Example, she was a generous benefactor to the school library. So the school library was receiving grant or help. So she's what? A generous benefactor. It means that she's doing a good act by providing help. Second example, the trust received great support from unnamed benefactor. Okay, so that means that the trust, the organization, the NGO is receiving support from unknown benefactor, right? Next, benefaction. So ben means good. Now faction means work. So good deed or good work is benefaction. Acha kaam, right? An act of showing kindness and goodwill is benefaction. For example, large number of their income come from benefaction. Right? Next, beneficiary. So, this is a simple word and I hope this is part of your vocabulary. So, let's break it down. Ban means, Bani means good. And fishery. By the way, fishery is not a root, but somehow it's related to profit or advantage. So, the recipient of funds or other benefits, especially money or property, when someone dies. So let's talk about some practical examples. If you've ever been to a bank to open an account, so the account opening forms, which is supposed to be very lengthy, somewhere it asks you to give the beneficiary names. Now, what is meant by the beneficiary names that you list down might be 1, 2 or whatsoever number of beneficiary names. So in case you die, they will get benefit of your saving, your money, and so, right? So now let's look at this example sentence. Who will be the main beneficiary of the cuts in income tax? Second example, he was the chief beneficiary of his father's will. It means that he was getting benefit from it, or he was getting benefit from his father's will. One more example I could share, that when the government wants to, develop policies, all right, or initiate projects, during the planning phase, the government thinks, all right, and wants to know that what will be the benefit of this project, or who will be the people who will get, benefit, or those the beneficiaries of the project. So in simple word, we could say that beneficiary means people who get benefit, advantage, or get something good out of something, right? So that is beneficiary. Okay, moving next. Bonhomie. I guess it's not part of your vocab. If so, good. If not, let's explore it. Friendly and approachable, easy to talk to. Someone who has friendly nature is a bonhomie. Alright? So let me ask you, are you a bonhomie? If you are a bonhomie, it means you are approachable and friendly in nature. Example sentence, the actors during the shooting were relaxed and full of bonhomie. Now, it could be that the actors are not so approachable, but during the shooting, they were relaxed so that and full of bonhomie. I mean, they were easy to be talked to, right? So the last word is bonanza. Now, I hope you might have heard this word. I guess that it's repeatedly used in media advertisement, right? So let's say that if you go to a market, somewhere you will find banners, okay, boards, signboards, which says bonanza offer. Right now, what is bonanza, or what is bonanza offer? A sudden happening that brings good fortune is bonanza. Right, so we have the root word bona, which means good, right, and bonanza means good fortune. All right, example sentence, June, July and August are bonanza months for tour operators in Pakistan. Okay, so now these are the summer months. Now in the summer months, people in Pakistan intend to go on vacations, right? So now the vacations are planned by tour operators. So it means that in summer months, the tour operators are doing good fortune just because their business is good. So they have bonanza business. Okay, all right, so that's all for today's lesson. A quick reminder that we have learned the root word bon, ben and benny, which means good, well or kind, right? So I hope today's lesson might have been beneficial for you. So guys, please, if the lessons are beneficial for you, do get subscribed, right, and stay connected. Thank you.